La la, yeah. La la, wait till I give my money right.
I'm in my prime, young nigga, I'm just tryna run through a check. Soon as you get a necklace, they be aiming for your neck. Half of these men who damn me at it ain't got no respect. And these catches used to curb me, now they wanna have sex.
What up, Royal Gang? It's your boy King CeeLo, and you already know we keeping this junk on the D-Lo. Now, today. Man, it's been so long since I said that, man. How y'all 2020 been, man? Like, all jokes aside, bro, like, I know I've been gone for a while, and I've been slacking, you know what I'm saying? But in 2021, we're gonna get back on the right track. You guys see my last video, I told you guys what I'm focusing on this year and why I've been gone and all that. Next year is my year. We're going back on YouTube. We're going back on the YouTube grind. You guys wondering where I've been at? All year, I've been focusing on my Instagram. Let's click on the video, man. If you guys really care, just click on the video. This video is not gonna be about where I've been. If you guys really care about it so much, then just go watch the video. But today's video, I'm building my first ever gaming PC, man. I know nothing's related to what I post on my channel. If you guys don't know me, I've been a gamer my whole life, man. I've been on console, bro. Like, y'all don't know me. Y'all don't know, like, the real me. I mean, y'all see what I'm on camera, and that's the real me. I ain't gonna lie. I don't sugarcoat nothing on camera. Y'all ain't never seen, like, the gamer side of me is what I'm saying. Yeah, man, this was a long process getting all the parts together and all that. In a second, I'm gonna show you guys all the parts I got. Like I said, it's a long process, man. I ordered some of my parts, like, almost 2 months ago at this point. The last part just got here today. I'm kind of nervous. I'm not gonna be building it by myself. My dad's gonna be helping me build it as well. I'm not sure how I'm gonna do this video. I'm not sure if I want to do a part vlog and like put clips inside the vlog, if that makes sense, like do a little voiceover as I'm talking. I mean, I still don't know if that makes sense. Like I said, man, I don't usually make content like this on my channel. As you guys can tell by the price, man, this was very expensive, man. I don't go cheap, man. You know me, I'm going all in. If I got the money and I got what I want, if I know what I want, I'm going all in. I'm not going for no cheap. No, that's not me. I'm sorry. There ain't nothing wrong with going cheap or whatever. You gotta do what you gotta do. But hey, for me, I'm not doing it. Yeah, man, I'm doing too much talking. Let me go ahead and show you guys the specs. Without further ado, here we go.
All right, guys. So starting out with the case, I went with the NZXT H510 Elite case. I went with this case because not only does it look nice, but it can also fit my RTX 3090 ROG Strix graphics card inside of it. Well, other cases, I didn't know they could do that, so my choice here was very simple. The case looks nice, it looks good for a beginner. It's also a very popular choice out there. A lot of people go with the NZXT cases out there. I did want to choose another case over it, but I just wasn't sure if the graphics card would fit inside of it, so it came down to if the card could fit inside of it, and I knew that this case could. So yeah, up next for the motherboard, I want the ROG Strix Z490E Gaming. To be honest, I'm not really sure why I went with this motherboard. I guess because of the price of it and how good it looked. Not to mention that my graphics card is also a ROG Strix or ROG Strix, whatever you guys want to say, whatever you guys want to call it. They were both ROG Strix, so I figured that they would both be compatible together. I didn't really do too much research on this motherboard. I just knew that it was a great motherboard. It had some great reviews online. So this came up to how it looked, and me not getting the wrong motherboard to fit my graphics card in there, because I didn't want to keep on getting new motherboards to find something that was finally compatible with my graphics card. So yeah, I think this was a great choice. You guys let me know in the comments if I did a good choice on the motherboard, and yeah. Alright guys, so for the RAM, I want the Dominator Platinum RGB from Corsair. Right off the top, as soon as I seen this RAM, I just knew that this was the one. Not to mention that it also has 32GB of memory on it. I wasn't going with the 64GB version of it, but that may have been a little bit overkill. But hey, what's overkill when you already spent $6,000 on a PC? You guys are probably asking, why did I go with the white version? Why didn't you go with the black version since you have an all-black PC? And it was a hard choice, but I wanted to go with the white version because it made my PC pop more. I didn't want everything in my PC to be black. I mean, that may have been smarter because it would have completed the build, all black build, if you guys want to have a build like that. But I just wanted my PC to pop more. Let me know if you guys think this was a good choice for my RAM to go with this RAM. But yeah.
Up next for the SSD, so I'm with two pairs of M.2s from Western Digital.
both 1 terabyte each. The reviews on these are pretty good. However, I wasn't completely sold once I got these. Not because of the quality or anything like that. The quality on these are amazing. They run fast, they run smooth. The problem here is 2 terabytes just isn't enough, especially with today's gaming. The games are getting bigger and bigger every day, and 2 terabytes just isn't gonna cut it anymore. I also got a SATA drive to go with this as well, and that's also 1 terabyte, but still, even with that, it's not enough space. In the future, I probably will get another terabyte or so just to give me some more space for these games. As I'm recording this video, I done used up 1 terabyte with one of these drives. That just goes to show you how big these games are getting, and it's how 1 terabyte just isn't going to cut it anymore. Besides that, you really can't go wrong with these. For my experienced PC gamers out there, let me know how you guys feel about these, and yeah.
For the CPU, I went with the i9-10900K from Intel. One of the best CPUs out there on the market right now, hands down. I really don't have to do too much talking about this CPU. It speaks for itself. If you guys want to find out more about this CPU, just do the research. Nothing comes close to this thing right here. There is another CPU coming out later on this year that can compete with this, but still, even with that, you can't go wrong with this right here.
Up next for the CPU, cooler, and fans, the one with the NZXT Kraken Z63. Not a bad choice here. If I'm not mistaken, there is another CPU cooler out there by NZXT that's better than this one. This one only has 2 fans while the other one has 3. But still, even with that, you can't go wrong with the CPU cooler. It gets the job done. If you guys care about looks like me, it also comes with a display screen. I would find this very helpful for beginners just because it shows you the temperature of your GPU and CPU as you're gaming. Without this thing right here, I don't think my PC would look as good as it does right now. But yeah.
Up next for the monitor, I want the Samsung Odyssey G7. This thing right here is an absolute beast. It comes with a refresh rate of 240Hz with a display of 1440p. I know that's a big no for some of you guys. You're probably asking, why would you pay so much for a monitor that isn't 4K? But think about it this way. Why would you spend more money on a 4K monitor that doesn't even have a decent refresh rate? Most 4K monitors out right now can't even pass a refresh rate of 60. And to today's standards, frames when you game, so that pretty much seals the deal right there.
Up next for the power supply, went with the ROG Thor 850 watt power supply. As you guys can tell by now, I pretty much went with ROG everything with this build right here. I'm not gonna lie, I don't know too much about power supplies. I just know they power everything in the system. Originally, I had purchased the 1250 watt version of this, but it never came, so I had to go with the 850 watt. 1200 watts is kind of overkill, so I guess that saved me some money right there. Besides that, this power supply is pretty clean. It does have RGB, as you guys can tell by these clips. 850 watts definitely gets the job done with today's standards.
And last but not least, for the PCIe slot, we have the RTX 3090 ROG Strix along with the 4K 60 Pro. I shouldn't really have to do any talking about this right here. You guys already know what this thing is about. The best graphics card out right now, hands down. This thing can easily run 4K Ultra on any game. Not to mention, this is the overclocked edition, so I don't have to worry about overclocking anything. The only problem I have with this graphics card right here is that the coil whine is so freaking loud. At first, I got scared because I didn't know what coil whining was, but then I researched it and found out it is completely normal. Besides that, I think it's pretty safe to say that I'm set with this graphics card for at least the next 5 years. I would definitely hope that, especially with how much money I spent on this thing. But yeah, that pretty much does it for the graphics card.
Alright y'all, so that's it for the specs. Hopefully I said everything right in that part. Like I said, I'm new to this, so I may have said some things wrong. That part actually took longer than I expected it to be. I forgot to tell you guys early on in the video that I just got off work. I'm recording this video on a Monday, and it is currently 4:35. I'm not sure how many days it's going to take to build all this stuff and then get everything installed and all that. Now that that's all out the way, we can finally get into the building process. So yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. Alright y'all, so we finally finna get into the building process. I still got all my stuff in the hallway, as you guys can tell. This guy done taking some thumbnail pictures. But now, it's time to show you guys the real tech guy.
Man, don't do all that.
Okay, you got. I told you, you gotta be in the video.
But you ain't gotta do all that.
You gotta. They gotta look at you though. Okay. Then say what up to him. You go. Yeah. You part of the video. Yeah. You ain't gonna be in too much, but.
Y'all wanna see me as the video goes.
So. If you guys got any questions, ask him, and he definitely knows. He's been working on computers his whole life, so that's why he's here. So I won't mess anything up. Ain't that right, Daddy? You guys let me know in the comments. I'm gonna put it right here, but you guys let me know in the comments. I'm gonna put the case right here. What's the best setup for you guys?
Put the case over here so you can be on your keyboard and stuff right here, right?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. But that monitor is big, so I don't know how that monitor.
Alright, so first thing you're gonna open up is the case.
The case? Alright.
You gotta have something to put everything in.
Yeah. Alright, let's get into it.
Alright, y'all. So let me go ahead and show you guys what we are done with so far. So far, we have the CPU installed, as you guys can tell. Also, this will focus. Come on, camera. So we got the RAM installed as well. And one SSD slot. I'm not sure. We're not sure where the other one goes, so we're just going to wait on that for right now. But that's installed. We got three parts installed so far. And then right now, we are opening the CPU fan that goes along with the NZXT case right here. How long have we been working on this, Daddy? About?
How long?
About an hour?
Yeah.
Y'all can leave in the comments if we're doing good so far. We only took an hour so far for three parts, so I'm not sure if that's good, bad, or what. Also, leave in the comments, what's the fastest time you guys have built a PC? I'm just curious, because some of you guys, y'all have been building PCs your whole life, so y'all probably can build like a PC, the whole PC in like an hour, so there you go, right? Okay. So y'all probably can build like a PC in an hour, so. Ooh, look at my waist. Oh my God, look at those days. I am spinning. All right, it ain't good enough.
2 hours in.
2 hours in, man. It is currently 7:37. What time did I tell you guys? I forgot what I told you guys what time we started it. But we're taking a little small break, man. We just got done installing the CPU cooler, as you guys can tell. We were struggling on this, though, aren't we? A little bit. The CPU cooler.
Just a little bit. Which order we should be going.
Yeah. We was doing it in the wrong order. And it was hard to find the motherboard. Our motherboard on YouTube with people like putting this CPU cooler on there, so we had to do it by ourselves.
Well, they're doing that motherboard, period.
Yeah, this motherboard, period. Let me know if you guys know about this motherboard. I was looking at the reviews. The reviews saying it was good, so I'm assuming it's a good motherboard, but I don't know. We'll just have to find out. It's so far so good. So a motherboard is a motherboard. As long as our pieces going there, we're straight, right, Daddy?
All right,
y'all, so we finally done with the break. I done gone ahead, took me a little quick shower and that. When I started making this video, I had just got off work, so I ain't got time to settle down. Soon I got home, I got straight into it. Should be finishing up around 10 o'clock, 10:30, I don't know. I know we probably not gonna get finished today. All right, y'all, so a little quick update. We got the motherboard set up. Now what we are doing is setting up the power supply. You just got done with the power supply, didn't you, Dad? Okay. So we're done with the power supply now. It's 10:28 right now. So yeah, I think we're almost done. I'm going to give you guys another update. We were stuck on the motherboard / CPU cooler / wiring, anything, cable management. People don't be lying with us up to this cable management stuff, man. Cable management is so hard. That's what we've been fooling with really most of the time. Cable management ain't no joke. So you guys are watching this video and you're thinking about building a new PC, y'all watching me seeing how I'm building my first PC, make sure you got your cable management down. You don't take your time and manage everything correctly, it can get frustrated.
All right, y'all, so now we are putting in the hard drive. So yep, we have officially installed that. Now moving on to
this wires now, right?
What else you got?
The graphics card and the capture card and the other fan, but we can do that some other. Yeah, I just realized that the power supply that I got is a RGB. It lights up. That part right there lights up, but we have to screw the back on, so that's what I'm saying. It's retarded. Like, I mean, it's still 850 watts, but if you guys get this power supply, don't get it for RGB. It's useless. Totally useless. Once we screw this back on, it defeats the purpose. Like, you're not gonna see nothing. And then the front of the case is blocking it too. So, if you guys are getting this power supply for RGB, it's pointless, because you're not getting none out of it. You remember I told you I'm gonna order another fan, because the other fan's coming on the way, and that's going up here.
That's three fans on there.
It's three fans.
Look at it. Look at the box. I got three fans.
It's only one fan here, Dad.
Oh, what is that down there?
What is what?
The big box.
That?
Yeah.
That's the graphics card.
Oh.
What are you talking about? You talking about this right here, right? You that big this right here?
Yeah.
That's the graphics card.
Okay, man.
That's the mouse. And that's the capture card.
Capture card.
Yeah, it's like why I can record gameplay and stream.
Oh.
You
funny then.
All right, y'all, we're gonna call it a night. It's currently 11:43.
Still stuck on the cable management. What would you trying to connect?
The heat sink fan.
He's trying to connect the heat sink fan to that or something. Oh, so I don't know. Shouldn't take this long, but hey.
It is what it is at this point. I'll pick up with you guys tomorrow. I'm tired. I got work in the morning. I know I'm going to be tired. Yeah, y'all. Catch you guys tomorrow.
3 days later.
All right, y'all. It's day number 2. Kind of, sort of, if you want to put it like that. We've only been working on the PC for about 3.5 days. But it's day 2 of me filming this video. And it's also a Saturday. I know that's a lot of stuff. But at the same time, like, yeah. I know this terrible math, but hey, we just gonna live with it. We just gonna live with it. But yeah, the reason why we waited so long to build it is because we didn't want to mess nothing up. We kind of think we know where the wires go, but we just want to be sure. So my dad's friend's gonna come over today and help us, like, make sure we're putting the parts in the right spot or the wires in the right spot. Like I said, man, this thing was $6,000. So we don't want to miss nothing up. Hopefully today we can get done with this. I'm kind of tired of making this. We should already been done with the build by now. It shouldn't take like 6 days to build a PC. So yeah, y'all. So by the end of day 2, you guys should see a complete build of my first ever PC. But yeah, y'all. Catch y'all when he gets here. Alright, y'all. So it's a change of plans.
What the fuck?
We're just going to have to make an appointment for someone to come build the PC for us. Because he didn't know where the wires went. It's getting frustrating, man, but hopefully y'all pays off in the end. I just want to get the PC done. Like, it really shouldn't take a week for me to be on the PC, bro. Like, this is probably like the longest PC build in history. As far as making a video on this, bro, it has to be the longest one. Most people out there already know what they're doing. Hopefully on day 3, 3's the charm, you know what I'm saying? And everything could be done and all that. Yeah, man, this wish me luck, bro. Alright, y'all, so a little quick update. I know y'all wondering what's going on right now. I thought you told us that we were done for the day. But apparently, I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all real quick. Look at that. Hey, we know what we're doing in there, right, Daddy? We know what we're doing.
You dropped it in any?
Hell yeah.
Alright, y'all, so we are finally about to turn on the we are finally about to turn on the PC. We'll give it a try and see if everything running smooth.
This is what we have so far.
Hopefully we don't die by the PC.
Thank you for the warranty.
Yeah.
So alright, here we go.
I like this. I like the way this feels.
Let's go.
Hey! The fan ain't working though.
So?
You gotta fail it.
I know.
There we go! Yes, sir! Oh my gosh. What a beauty.
We did it. We did it.
Look at the PS. Oh my gosh.
Hate me.